So this is the hill overlook of Todos Santos, which I think is like the coolest little town in the Baja. I mean, you have the huge resort towns of Cabo San Lucas and San Jose de Cabo and La Paz, but outside of that, this is kind of like a median size, and it's just big enough that it gives you a number of restaurants and amenities, but it's still small and quaint, which is really cool. And it's really green too, comparatively. Again, off this main stretch, it's pretty much dirt roads, but it still gives the authentic Mexican feel, as opposed to like San Jose, Cabo, and Cabo San Lucas, which are just huge tourist towns and super crowded and, you know, it just feels like a resort town. So that's where I just got gas at this Pemex. And up here to the right is the town center park where the kids will be playing at. I think they just got out of school, so they might actually be there this time of day. And there's Rebecca and Tim doing cart witnessing. So that's Rebecca, Tim, and Larray. Tim is a really cool dude. They do a full-time house-sitting gig on this multi-million dollar home on the ocean edge. And he does other odds and ends jobs. He does some construction, and then he sings and plays the guitar like at some resorts. I'm gonna head back down and this is someone who doesn't know where they're at or where they're going and is just gonna park in the middle of the street and make me go around her. As I start to pass her, she starts going again. Typical. I'm not gonna say any cliches, but I think it's unspoken. It's just truism, really. And so, right down this street right down this street is where we go to our house, and then there's cool little restaurants. This is they call it the Gringo Street because this is where all the gringos hang out, because it's like full of art stuff and restaurants and bars. And so, like I said, Todos Santos is like pretty cool. I think it's the best size town. Besides, like I said, Las Perillas, which is more of a kite surfer town, but Tequila Sunrise. And now she's passing me. How typical. All right.
Couple or family can take a bucket?
What's your name?
Angie. Do I have enough for everybody?
Hi, Angie. Nice
for
to meet you.
For each family group to take a bucket.
Where do they hatch?
They hatch underground.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So the nests are like 2 feet deep underground, and they hatch underground, and then they crawl to the top of it.
In there?
Uh-huh. Inside here, because at this time of year, the temperature is too low for the nest to hatch. Like if a turtle nested out here, and we just left it there, it wouldn't hatch at this time of year. Yeah, the temperature's too low, so the eggs just rot, unfortunately. Half of the year, the nests make it, and then in the winter, like, we would just work October through March, and we built this greenhouse to bring the temperature up.
So what's the difference? How many more do you save?
100%. Well, so, from a nest of 100 eggs, zero would hatch in the winter.
Where do you have to go, little guy?
And so, all our nests hatch. They, the rate is like between 70% and 80%.
Did he get out on his own?
No, I think he set it down. No.
He's going in the right direction.
Yeah.
They're 1 day old.
No, they're not 1 day old. They just hatched today.
Oh, today?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you can't save sea turtles for a day because. Like in nature, they hatch, they climb up out of their nest, and then they run to the ocean.
Huh.
And
so,
we try to, you know, copy nature as much as possible. The only thing different that we're doing is sort of covering the nest so that they hatch. Because without, these
average neighborhood pet, which is horses down here in Todos Santos. Apparently, that cowboy over there just brings them over to the empty, vacant lots and lets them chomp down on the overgrown grass. So it's free feed for him. So this is right in front of the Tortoise Beach, which we're gonna head down to here in a second. And this is a multi-million dollar house right on the beach. So another part of Todos Santos.
It's cows crossing.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, they're trying to make this little place a big deal.
There's nothing to it, but it's a couple hours.
Yeah, see, we drove through here, but we were looking for the restaurant.
Yeah, we did not look at this.
Because, you know, the brother was going on and on about the restaurant, so we're like, looking, which restaurant is it? And we didn't even look up and see Eiffel's Tower.
Doesn't look that big from here, but you can see the shorter one there. But anyway, there's like, because this kind of sits in a hole here, so you get an inversion and the pollution from the smelter, from the silver smelter. And so they're like, we got to build a really tall tower.
So this is a little pub in El Truente, where Eiffel's Tower is located, and Mark finally found his IPA on tap. Peyote Pale Ale. More hops than a cacaracho. Hold on. Yes. Okay, it's filming.
We're ended.
They're so cute.